Hi, I'm here taping with Hardworking Moms New Service. It's not that we forgot about all you all that's locked up in jail or prison or anything. I've been very busy helping the senators, the governor, and them to make plans to help our people. And to say that, we have Senator Bear, State Representative Brenda Carter, Angela Powell, Oakland County Commissioner, as well as Dave Coacher, who's the Oakland County Executive, and our first African-American Lieutenant Governor, Garland Gilchrist. Ooh. Yes. And God have been so awesome to Evangelist Taylor and put my feet's altar and go on the Senate floor and be helping change laws and bills with these people that I helped get in office to better for the people that's lost in prison.
Come on, man.
To say that, right now, Hardworking Moms have a new director. We have new things that's going forward here in 2020.
Wow.
And you will be able to still go to vtaylor305@gmail.com as well as 248-309-0579 and send in a request now, because I have help now to keep doing this once a month. Now we have Elder Bell, Dre Bell, and you may see the Bell family come on and preach here for 2020 on Hardworking Moms.
Come on, Hardworking Moms. Doing it big.
Yes. So we're going to start a new website for you also.
Yeah.
And he going to connect that up with Hardworking Moms Facebook page for that.
Come on, man.
Now, we also have Cameras and Phone Bank Grassroots Award that you will be seeing, having the first black tie that we will be putting on in January to bring you to attention of who to vote for in 2020.
Come on.
But right now, Hardworking Moms is about to bring the word, and Elder Bell, you want to pray to them this morning?
Yep, I pray to them. Father God, we come to you in spirit and truth. This day you may rejoice and be glad. We thank you for this day. Thank you for this new year. We thank you that you just bless us all according to your word. We thank you and praise you for this mighty woman of God and all that she do, and then her whole vision and all that she do for her city of Pontiac and all that she do worldwide. We thank you and praise you that this word that we bring forward be a blessing to somebody that's watching all over the world, all over the city of Detroit, all over the city of Pontiac. We thank you and we praise your name. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Now, Hardworking Moms just didn't start with God didn't lead just Hardworking Moms for a minute. For 2020, ever since 2018, I have partnered up with LBR, Life Beyond Reentry, with Deborah Black.
Wow.
To help bring inmates from around the world.
Wow.
So you all will be having to send in to people that's in jail before they go to prison to partner up with a reentry program with Deborah Black called Life Beyond Reentry.
Wow.
She's a very good lady, and we want her to get a building. So anybody out there got a building? We need this building for Life Beyond Reentry.
That's a blessing for real.
Yes, she got a 360 program that helped.
Man.
And she will be on in January to talk about it here in the studio.
That's powerful, because I remember when you first started the Hardworking Moms TV show, and you started the mission to be able to reach out to the inmates. And, I mean, you did a lot of big things with that. I remember Kwame Kilpatrick.
We still write for Kwame.
Yeah, I remember that.
And his father.
They reached back out to you.
Now we have reached out. We got a lot of inmates that have come home. Robert from Ward that came home that was doing life beyond a life without a possibility of parole.
For real?
Yeah, he came home.
Come on, man.
He came home. He came home last year. So we still writing to them and everything, but are also helping the senators on the floor to change bills, to get the bills changed over where they can
powerful.
Do the things they need to be done.
And then President Obama.
Yep, and wrote to President Obama to go clean the prison up, and he did a beautiful thing. He sent me back a beautiful letter, too.
Come on now.
Now, right now, I'm working with all the presidents.
That's big.
I had to move Hardworking Mom and start Cameras and Phone Bank Grassroots Award because the politicians couldn't mix with Hardworking Mom.
Wow.
So I had to start Cameras and Phone Bank Grassroots Award.
Wow.
So all them that's running for office, I can sit with them and talk about how we can go to the Senate floor, write a bill, and change a bill. Sure. So we'll talk about that with Camison and Phone Bank Grassroots.
So I got one question, too. So what's somebody watching right now, and let's say they got somebody in their family or friend that's in prison, but you know they didn't do nothing wrong. They got, you know, what can they do to... Can they reach out to you to try to help them?
Oh, yeah. All I got to do is call at 248-309-0579 or vtailor305@gmail.com.
Because they might have had an unfair trial. You know, they may be innocent and they may just be doing time
but,
for no reason.
Okay, so you know I can't really say about what I know. So
for sure.
But I'm about to tell y'all a little secret. Oakland County got Jessica Cooper that's running for Oakland County prosecuting attorney.
Come on, man.
But we got a new lady that's running that's a judge that gave up her seat. Her name is Karen McDonald's.
Wow.
And she's going to be running for Oakland County prosecuting attorney in Oakland County. Her name is Karen McDonald. So we're going to get her on Camison and Phone Bank Grassroots Award and talk about that, but now let you bring the message.
Yep, okay.
Because I think you on tour with me to see, you don't see a lot go down.
I mean, I'm saying like a whole lot, you know what I mean? It's like you, this message, it go hand in hand with it, you know. We're going to go straight to the scripture, Proverbs 3:6.
Okay.
In all thy ways acknowledge him,
and he shall direct thy path.
That path.
Yes.
Nah,
I like the
now.
Whole thing. Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with thy whole heart and lean not to your own understanding, but acknowledge him in all thy ways and he will direct your path. Because see, right now, people say I boast too much.
Come on.
Well,
man.
I can't do nothing but boast about God.
Come on.
Because I allow God to carry me.
Come
see,
on.
We fell short.
That's direction, though.
Yeah.
Carry him, right?
Right.
He's going to direct our path. He's going to carry us in that path.
I'm allowing him to keep me in his arms.
Come on.
I am his child.
Come on.
Cuddle your baby to the bosom and keep directing me to do your work.
Direction.
Not my will, your will.
His will be done, is in heaven.
Yeah.
And you talk about direct our path, direction. It's like a map. Some people read a map and they don't know where to go. And they look at the map and they tell you where to go. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you know.
Like even nowadays, you can type in an address, right?
Yeah.
Boom.
Yeah.
And it's gonna take you right
to where you got to go. I like God carrying me. I know because if he carrying me.
Come on now.
Now I'm telling you, Elder Bell, God carrying me.
Come on.
And I ain't got to worry. I don't have a worry with a thing about what it's doing and how it's going to be done. Because I'm trusting in the Lord 100.
Woo. Come on.
Because see, he don't fail me. I fail
man.
Him. We can get in our way.
We can get in our way. We can get weak. That's the thing about it. See, God, he spoils us, right?
Yeah.
So, God being something great for us.
Yeah.
Next day, we turn around, it don't go your way. You be like, get the doubt.
Yeah.
Doubt times. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it's like, that's why we got to always lean on the God. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
it's like, for example, this chair right here, right?
Yeah.
You have faith to sit on this chair, and what you knew the chair wasn't going to fall.
Yeah.
Now, if you sat in this chair, and you knew it was the legs was weak, you wouldn't even sit down and flop in the seat like this, you know what I mean?
That's
we leaning on a guy like I'm leaning on his chair.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, see, you lean on him. I like the word that he carried me in his own. Because they tell you only see one set of footprints in that sand, bro.
Come on.
So I love that part right there myself, okay? Just keep carrying me, God, because see, my rent been paid, lights been paid, my gas been paid by him carrying. I got a new car.
Come on.
In 2019.
Ooh. Come on.
I got
come on.
God has sent me 3 or 4 checks in the mail that I didn't even know nothing about.
We're talking about checks you didn't even know was going to come.
You know?
You talking about you literally what? Went to the mailbox, right? And you see a check and you're like, huh?
Said I had a lawsuit money and called you early enough, come pay my...
Come on.
Pay my tab ahead of time.
Because all that way, because you acknowledge him and he's directing your path. You know what I mean?
I only just do that. I have a church home too, but I pay my tithes to the
church. Powerful woman of God, too. Yeah. Powerful woman of God. Yeah. And, pay my tithes. And she the first what? Lady
Bishop.
In Pontiac.
Yeah, she the first.
Congratulations. Bishop Lee, right?
Bishop Teresa Lee.
Congratulations. I had the opportunity to do the taping for the event, and it was a powerful event. Man.
She's the first Bishop of Pontiac.
Come on.
She was ordained bishop over there in Nigeria.
Yeah.
And they came to, we put on a
That event was nice. They showed up and showed out.
Yeah. Her church is at 123 West Columbia in Pontiac.
Wow.
And she's called New Birth International.
Come on, that's powerful.
And it's a beautiful thing. I've been up under two women leadership bishops
now.
Come on, man. My most important one that I truly miss is... Bishop Stevenson.
Come on now.
Remember Bishop Stevenson? Yeah. She groomed me into what I am today.
Yeah.
She took good care of me and my kids and helped all me. My babies were, all six of my children was born. Then Reverend Durham.
Come on, Reverend Durham.
Reverend Durham.
Come on.
Yes. Reverend Durham.
Come on now. Powerful man of
God. Took me from my Ursha board to deaconess, from the deaconess to evangelist, from evangelist. Now I'm taking care of the inmates for God.
Come on.
So God is, I'm truly letting God work through me.
Come on.
Truly.
Man.
And it's a good thing when you let God do his will. Yeah, yeah. I sit with governors, senators.
Come on.
And people.
Your 2019 has been packed with, talk about excellent. He's sitting you with kings and queens, you know. He's sitting you amongst the great leaders.
Yeah.
And
I got a surprise for you. Guess what? I was just voted woman in leadership power.
Come on now.
I've been voted woman in leadership, leadership power. I was nominated. So I got to see in 2020 as I'm going to get that award. Come on now. We come to bring the word.
You're
talking about me.
We're talking about God. You know that. I said, we in all our ways, he's going to direct our path. You know, so you even go to.
Tell them about the new website you about to build
Come on. Hardworking Moms. It's going to be beautiful. It's coming real soon. Hardworking Moms is going to talk about all that you do. On that side.
Yeah.
On your side of the business. You know what I mean?
In the ministry base.
Come on.
All of you all that got people locked up in prison, I really need y'all right now to start sending me or calling me with people that's in prison so I can help them get home. Or even if they going to jail or
That's powerful. That's a powerful ministry.
Or going to jail. I can go to court with them and take LBR there with you, where they can sit up there and ask the judge, don't even sentence them.
Come on.
To put them in a program now.
Come on.
So, yeah.
Come on.
Let's do this.
That's powerful. That's powerful. So, yeah. So back to the scripture and all the ways of knowledge him. He direct our path. You know what I mean?
You're bringing the word now.
So, you can even go, let's say, to the lion's den, right?
Yeah.
And you go to when he was in the lion's den, right?
Yes.
You know,
three in the den. Felt like four was
come
in
on.
There because it was
on.
Cool and,
come
and
on.
Didn't have no heat or nothing.
Come on
so
now.
So they looked up and they seen three in there, but it was
come
four
on. So you,
standing up
woo!
In the midst.
Come on, in the midst of it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that was keeping it cool.
Because somebody right now is watching, they in their own lion's den right now.
Yeah, see, because you could be in your mind. Messed up where Satan got your mind the screws to want you to do wrong.
Yes, come
and
on.
Can't keep straight. Can't stay above them.
Because your lions could be different things. Your lions then you can be dealing with. Depression can be your lions.
Yeah.
Stress can be your lions.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Hunger.
Hunger. Come on, man.
Uh-huh.
Come on.
Overweight.
Pain.
Yeah.
Anything.
Yeah.
You know.
Yes.
Anything that's on track to try to stop you in your place.
That's right.
It could be your lions. It's fear.
That's right.
But then the Bible says, God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a strong mind. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So when you look at that, it's like that represents the lions is fear.
Well,
you got to learn how to deal with the fear. You got to learn how to come face to face. And that's what he did when he's in the lion's den.
Yeah.
He came face to face with his fears and said, guess what? Not today.
Yeah, not today.
Not today.
Well, people be mad at me and say, you wake up like every day. that you don't have no problem. No, because see, come I on. Wake up with the mind. My mind is the Christ mind. Come on. Can't nobody master my mind but God.
Come on.
And see, if
come
you on. Open your eyes up, continue, when you instead of putting your feet on the floor, when you open your eyes and say, my mind, take my mind out and give me the Christ mind.
Come on.
For this day, if it's Monday, say Monday, God, today is Monday. Take my mind out and give me the Christ mind. Put your mind in my mind. Even though somebody come up against me, you keep me in good spirits. You greet, ask God, let the Christ in me greet the Christ in you today. Come today, on. Monday, I need you every day until 12 o'clock midnight to greet the Christ in them where we'll have a perfect day. Yep. And these the affirmations I say.
You got to stand on and allow
every day.
Yep, and allow the Christ in you to be in control. True. Because we all
that's
got...
What, that's where the Holy Ghost come cause in.
We all got flesh, which means we all get have weak. Flaws. Yep. We all get weak. You know what I mean? We all sin.
Yep.
We all have issues.
That's
so
right.
So that's what it's about when you have Christ. You seek first the kingdom of God. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
and righteousness, all things should be added. You got to seek God first. You know, me sitting here as a Christian, I never plan to be perfect, and I never will plan to be perfect. You know what I mean?
No, this, ain't this nobody ain't, perfect
come
but
on,
the
man.
God.
This walk ain't perfect. This walk is a walk. It's literally, man, you know what I mean? It's a marathon.
Listen, it ain't about the walk.
Come on.
It is about, you got to be woman, man enough come to on. Give all your burdens to God.
Yep.
Leave them there. Walk that walk with him.
Ooh.
Let him, don't look back, and don't let Satan put no doubt,
come on.
No stress.
Come on.
Or nothing in your mind.
Come on.
Cause they just, to be honest with you, they just trials and tribulations.
And they stepping stones. That's why I say so. All the words of knowledge, he directing your path. So God directing your path, right? So you going this way, and here come a roadblock. You know what I mean? There may be stress. So what you got to do? You got to fight that roadblock. You got to somehow hurdle that roadblock.
Yeah. You got to say them affirmations. You got to pick up that Bible.
Come on.
And say, God, listen.
Come on.
I promise in this Bible, in these words, you promised me in this Bible that you had me. You promised me that I will have a perfect peace. I'm asking you to do just
and
what your
strong.
Will say.
And stand strong on it. That's what it comes down to, like standing strong on the word. So this life that we live, see, this is about continue to elevate your thought process and elevate your mind and elevate the way that you think and elevate the way that you see things. That's why it said the race ain't given to the swift, it's those who endure to the end. So in this marathon that we walk, the closer you walk to God, right?
Yeah.
We supposed to get stronger in the Lord through every trial and tribulation that we go through.
That's
period.
Right. That's right.
Point blank. Not more, not less. That's what this life is about. It's about learning.
Yeah.
It's about moving forward. It's about growing.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, because to be honest with you, Evangelist Taylor have really grown.
Yeah, for sure.
I have really grown because
that's what it's about. Growth.
Yeah, when I was 15, I probably wouldn't have been this well mannered.
Come on.
Respectful.
Come on, let's go.
Enduring.
For sure.
To the end.
For sure.
And knew God had my back.
For sure.
Back then.
Fighting.
I didn't know
fighting
what
I
know now.
Come on, fighting for it.
And how to sit back without getting stressed.
Come on, fighting for it.
Strain.
Come on.
Endure.
Woo!
Sit back and be mad. And,
man.
And talk about why this ain't going that way.
Yeah.
When you give it to God and leave it there. And don't think about it and
come
get
on.
Busy.
Come on.
Man, your mind is clear.
It's clear.
You think more.
Yep.
You healthy.
Yep.
You smile more.
Yep.
Yeah.
Come on.
You don't have no worries.
Come on. And then blessings, guess what? And then
blessings.
They're going to come upon you. You
listen,
know what I'm saying?
I know. Don't
you know,
tell me about the blessing. I got a 2011 Ford Focus out there in my driveway.
Man.
I got an office that was set up that's laid out in
come
my
on,
house.
Come on now.
Man, I'm telling you. I don't worry about
come
what
on,
to
now.
Do. And if somebody call me, I'm coming.
Come on.
You know what I'm saying?
Come on. God
I'm
is
coming.
God is
I'm
good
coming.
And God
I'm
is
coming.
Faithful. You
yeah,
know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Got, that's
yeah,
why
yeah,
that's
yeah,
why
yeah.
when you walk this walk, look, you just gotta walk this walk. And walk it in confidence and knowing that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can think and all that we can see.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Mm-hmm.
That's the God that we serve. Like, it's real.
Yeah,
it's real.
Yeah,
it's real,
yeah.
My baby. Y'all here. I'm telling you, dog. God, like, look, God is real, bro.
I like it where
God is real.
Catch me, Elder Bell, if I'm wrong. Where it said, we not supposed, what we can't see, the unseen.
Come on.
So we supposed to have faith in what we don't see.
Yeah.
And know that it is.
Through the eyes of faith.
Faith. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Because see, I look at it. I don't look at what I see here. I see things in the
It's like you putting on some spiritual glasses.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's like you seeing into the future.
Yeah.
That's what it's about, seeing, mm-hmm. believing,
mm-hmm.
and continue to believe no matter what.
Yeah.
Because it's gonna always come back around. You know what I'm saying? God, the blessings come, they're gonna boomerang right back on you.
Yeah.
Boom. Gonna bounce around this whole room like a pinball. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So y'all, you ready for them blessings to come just ricochet through you and through your whole family? That's what it's about.
Yeah.
Man, come on.
And if y'all want to sow a seed into hardworking moms, you can. You can go to one of the address is 160 J. Hubbard Lane, Unit 1, Pontiac, Michigan, 48342. Again, 160 J, alphabet J, Hubbard Lane, Unit 1, Pontiac, Michigan, 48342. Because I'm looking for to help people to buy. I have 4 people on death row in California.
Wow, for real?
Yeah, but Kevin Cooper, that's on death row there. I have 7 or 8, 9 judges say he innocent.
Come on.
9 judges say he innocent. So we can't just order him paper and pencil. We have to buy it and send to him. So my funds are getting a little low. Y'all donate to Mr. Kevin Cooper. Send me a couple of, help me get him paper, notebook, and pencil so he can write back. And I send it to California.
For sure.
And help him like that. I got a box that got to go off today. He can only get
so much. Come on.
And I help them too. I help any and everybody.
Come
because
on.
That's what God did for us when he walked this world.
Oh, come on. God's the love of the Lord.
Yeah.
God so loved the world that he
gave his only begotten son.
He gave his only begotten son.
And when his son hung on the cross.
For us all.
Yeah.
Facts.
Hung on the cross.
Real talk.
The father, the Lord couldn't even watch his son get crucified. That's the reason it got dark. It tells me that he had to turn his head and it got dark.
Come on. Come on.
Do you understand me? So you got to also think about, if God gave his only son we only lent to one another for a little while.
Come on.
We need to start investing in the love for one another.
Come on.
Because we're not here long.
Come on.
Where you can blink your eye, walk out the door before you can get in your car. Good, you could have been a lost your mama, sister,
come
brother,
on.
Cousin, aunt, great aunt, friends round the corner.
Come on now.
Round the corner just that quick, bro.
That's why you gotta just be thankful.
Yeah.
For these moments that we have.
Yeah.
Be thankful for what God's done for you. Just be thankful for you got family in it. Just be thankful for what God has done for you. And most importantly, be thankful what God is doing, because it comes down to just staying on that path. Even when you stumble and fall, even when you gotta crawl.
Yeah.
Stand on that path, stand in that direction, just staying close to God, keeping God in your heart. And that's what God is about. That's what this walk is about. God judges us from this right here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He don't judge us from the surface of what other people may see or what other people may think about you or what we may think about other people. This world that we live in, it's a judgmental world. It's so fast. Everything moves so fast.
Now listen. In the Bible, it teaches us we're not supposed to judge one another, because he gonna judge us according to we judge one another.
Come on. Come on.
And I ain't trying to judge nobody.
Come on.
Because see, most women don't want to tell age. Come here in March, I'll be 60.
Come on.
He wrote a book.
Come on.
They started out that book called Veronica Anita Taylor.
Come on,
when
blessed.
He wrote that book,
come on.
On Judgment Day, he gonna open that book.
Come on.
And tell me what I done and what I didn't do in that book.
Come
so
on.
I don't need to be taking on nothing no more that I already undone when I was stupid and ignorant.
Come on.
I can say
Come on.
Didn't know the Lord.
Come on.
And now I do.
Come on.
I got to be, he got to answer to those that when I didn't know.
Come on.
So that book that was written, that said Veronica Anita Taylor.
Come on.
I got the answer to that on Judgment Day.
Come on.
So why would I sit
there? Come on, bless.
and judge you,
come on,
and others about what they done when I'm supposed to be my brother's keeper.
Come on, brother's keeper. You know what I mean?
You
come on,
what I'm saying?
That's what it comes down to. So look, if you're watching right now, because we run out of time, we probably got we got like three minutes left. So look, if you're watching right now, look, you can give it all to God right now.
You can I need God y'all right to bend down right now. Come on, Father God.
Come on, Father God.
As I come humble, I know how.
Come on, Jesus' name. Come on.
I need you, Lord, to come into my life.
My heart right now in the
and take on and
come
give
on.
Me the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Come on.
Now, the Holy Ghost is Jesus. What convicts us to keep us on a straight and a narrow.
Come on.
So we need that Holy Ghost to keep convicting our souls so when we get saved,
come on.
We can stay saved
come on.
And we can try to walk. That walk ain't going to be perfect.
Come on.
You're going to fall along the way.
Woo, come
but
on.
It's how you
come
get
on.
Up and ask God to forgive you.
Come on.
Because every day you live until the day he come and take us away, we're going to stumble along the way.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen. Jesus' name, amen. Now look, that's now you can walk that walk and just allow God to just work in your life. I'm telling you, this is the best decision you made today. 2020, giving yourself to God, giving your life to God, giving it all to God, let go and let God.
Well, before we go.
Come on now.
Tell them about.
Come on.
Your mother, Pastor Darlene.
Yep.
And Pastor Sarah, where they can go visit the church.
Yep, Pastor Darlene and Sarah, Exciting Life Christian Center. You can go to excitinglifechristiancenter.org to get more information about them. Also, BGNTVGospel.com, Bell Global Network. We're doing big things. Also, YouTube. We're on YouTube with all our shows. With This Mighty Woman of God, all her shows on YouTube as well. You can follow me at choirboybell.com, at choirboybell.com. Hey, we're doing big things. We're on Facebook. I mean, we showing out for God.
For God. And don't forget, anybody that you got in jail or going to court,
she's speaking facts.
Don't make a difference if it's Wayne, Macomb County, or Oakland County.
Come on.
I'm coming.
Woo!
Call me, and I'll come, and I'll bring LBR, Life Beyond Reentry,
come on, man.
Deborah Black. And we're going to come and help you as much as we can.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen. And let 2020 talk about be the best years of your life.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Bye-bye.
What's up, everybody? This is your girl, Vicky Winans, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy, D. Hattie, watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
Hi, everybody. I'm telling you, everything that happened to me that was good, God did it. I'm Evelyn Turrentine, AG, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Pastor D. Alexander Bullock of Preachers of Detroit, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Bishop Edgar Vann of Second Ebenezer Church in Detroit, Michigan, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, I'm Bernadette Stannis. You know me best as Thelma from the TV show Good Times. And you are watching Bell Global Network.